lesson is to write numerical expressions as powers or in expanded form. So set up your notes and put a section for questions and conclusion. We're going to start with 2 to the 4th power. This is a power. And I'm going to highlight the base in yellow. I'm going to highlight the exponent in pink. And together they make a power. And so this is written in power form. We can also write it in expanded form. So a power has a base and an exponent. The base is the number that's multiplied together. The exponent says how many times to multiply it together. So we repeat the multiplication. 2 times 2 times 2, we have 4 copies of the base. And we multiply those together, so the value of this would be 16. So the value is 16, the expanded form is 2 times 2 times 2, and the power form is 2 to the 4th power. So let's do some examples. I'm going to highlight just one copy of the base in the expanded form. So I highlighted the 4, and I'm going to highlight the negative 2. I guess I didn't highlight the negative 2 or the 5 or the negative 7, but those are the bases, and that's what I'll fill in. And I like to use color to create the place where I'm going to fill in. I'm going to fill the base in where it's yellow. I'm going to fill the exponent in where it's pink. And notice how I include the parentheses when they're around the base. So negative 2, negative 7, and 5 all have parentheses. So I include those in the base. And I just count up how many times I've multiplied them together. And that's what the exponent is. So however many copies of the base you see multiplied together, that's the exponent. So 4 to the 3rd power, negative 2 to the 4th power, negative 7 to the 5th power, and 5 to the 7th power. So now we're going to take a look and see if we can determine if values are going to be positive or negative. So again, I'm going to highlight the base, I'm going to highlight the exponent in pink. So that's the first thing that we do. Then we have to come up with a way to determine if the value is going to be positive or negative. It turns out that if there is a positive base, then the value is positive. But if the base is negative, then every other time it's negative, and every other time we multiply it, it's positive. So on the even times, it's positive. On the odd times, it's negative. So if the base is negative and the exponent is positive, we will have a positive value. But if the base is negative and the value, if the base is negative and the exponent is negative, one more time, if the base is negative and the exponent is odd, then the value will be positive. I know I just wrote, the value will be negative. That is a mistake where I wrote positive right there, and we're going to fix it as soon as I'm done writing. Okay, so we're going to drag this over, and this is actually supposed to be negative. So if the base is negative, the value is negative if the exponent is odd. And we'll do some examples to see why that is. So our first example, has a positive base, so the value is positive. Our second example has a negative with no parentheses, so the value will be negative, no matter what, whether it has an odd or even exponent. The next one has a negative base and an odd exponent, so the value will be negative. The next one has a negative base and an even exponent, so the value will be positive. I'm going to stop it right there, back it up, let you get caught up, and then we're going to switch to another video. Okay, so now what we're going to do is write each power in expanded form and find the value. So 9 to the second power in expanded form is, our base is 9 and our exponent is 2. So that's 2 copies of our base multiplied together. So the value is 81. For number 15, this is our base is 3/4. And we have 2 copies of it, so we multiply them together. Our exponent says how many times we multiply it together. So that's 9/16. Number 17, our base is 1. It doesn't matter how many times you multiply 1 together, it's always going to be 1. Okay, now, it's tempting to copy sometimes the whole power, so we don't want to do that. It's not negative 5 squared 2 times, it's negative 5 2 times. And here's an example of a negative base with an even exponent. There's only 2 of them, and that's a negative times a negative, and so the answer is going to be positive. That's positive 25 is the value. And let's do a few more examples. Let's start to compare a couple of different numbers. Okay, let's compare negative 3 squared with parentheses or without parentheses. So I'm highlighting the base first. And then I'm going to highlight the exponent. 3 squared is 3 times 3. 3 times 3 is 9, and the negative remains on the outside. It's not inside parentheses. So the value is negative 9. If we include the negative inside the parentheses, it's a negative times a negative. This is a power with a negative base and an even exponent. So the value is going to be positive. And 9 is greater than negative 9. 2 to the third power, the base is 2 and the exponent is 3, so we multiply 2 times 2 is 4, we multiply it times 2 one more time and we get 8. 3 squared is 3 times 3, that's the base times itself twice. This 2 says to do that twice. Nine is greater than 8. And finally, let's compare negative 2 to the third power with parentheses or without parentheses. With parentheses, it's negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. Without parentheses, it's negative on the outside and then just 2 times 2 times 2. Both of these are going to have the same value of negative 8.